All right, so this is a video to go along with the article I wrote for Spearing Magazine at the end of 2017, where I was discussing why, because of the dive reflex, it would be advantageous for a spearfisherman to just do dry breath holds on the couch, especially if they've been out of the water for a long time. Because I'm limited in the amount of words I can use, I didn't, you know, get a chance to fully get into the whole dive reflex, so that's for the purpose of this video. So the dive reflex, or the mammalian dive reflex, is a series of well-documented, well-understood physiological responses to when we hold our breath underwater. So dolphins, seals, and whales, they're mammals, right? We as human beings, we're mammals, right? So, you know, they're full-time residents in the water. We are part-time residents in the water, some of us more than others. So genetically encoded in every human being on the planet, whether you want it or not, is this dive reflex, and it's gonna be more active, more powerful based on what you're doing. So two things, parts of the dive reflex I'll discuss because I think the most interesting. So first is this idea of bradycardia. And bradycardia is simply a fancy name for lowering of the heart rate. So we see upwards of about a 50% decrease in the heart rate when we're holding our breath. And this is great for us as free divers because that heart rate lowers, that's gonna lower our oxygen consumption. So obviously that's gonna be a benefit for us. This is triggered one by breath holding. So every time we're holding our breath, we're gonna start to get that. We can also trigger it. Something you see a lot of competitive freedivers doing is you'll always see them in the water with their mask on the forehead, breathing through their snorkel, face down. And what we're doing is, another thing that triggers the bradycardia beside the breath holding is cool water across the eyes. So just getting water across the eyes like that will drop the heart rate, right? So if you got a, a bowl, got a snorkel, stuck your face in it, breathe through the snorkel, had the eyes exposed to that cooler water, you're gonna see that heart rate drop. Okay, so, you know, the way to bring that out the strongest is do what the competitive freedivers do, which is when you get to the spot, hop off the boat, mask on the forehead, snorkel in, and just breathe up like that for 3 to 5 minutes. Now, you know, I understand spearfishermen, when they get there, they're excited and they want to go get in the water first in, first fish, and you may not want to or be able to sit there on the surface for 35 minutes. But if you can do it, try it. It absolutely will help. I had some tournament guys years and years ago that I was working with, and they're like, look, Ted, we get to the spot, we got to get in, we got to go, then we got to go to the next spot. So they're like, you know, that's absolutely not an option. So what they were doing is they were putting their mask on the boat trip and filling it with cool water, right? And just hanging out that way, that cool water and the mask on the eyes is, starting that bradycardic response and starting to kick in that dive reflex. So that's an option. That's an option as well. And then ultimately, you know, another thing you can do is just do dry breath holds, right? There's no reason on the boat trip out you can't do multiple dry breath holds, or what I like to say is hold your breath till it hurts, right? Just and wait, you start having some contractions, right? Just doing dry breath holds like that will kick in the dive reflex. That's basic freediving physiology. I don't care how long, even if you're untrained, have no ability to hold your breath, and you're going to hold your breath for 30 seconds, you want to hold your breath longer, do it again. You'll probably be able to do 40 seconds. And you want to do it longer, do it again. Each time you hold your breath, you're kicking in that dive reflex, right? And that's why you know that as a spearfisherman, you make that first drop of the day, your dive sucks, right? You short bottom time, contractions come really early, yet after an hour in the water, right, you really start feeling better. So, you know, the idea is why not start that process on the boat trip out and just do some dry breath holds on the way out. Hey, second part of the dive reflex, and this is really cool, it's called splenic contraction. So the spleen is a reservoir for red blood cells, right? And so the spleen, and we've documented this in studies, when freedivers hold their breath, that spleen can compress, right? And then what it does is it shoots out more red blood cells in the bloodstream, right? Raising that hematocrit level. So hematocrit level is, you get your blood drawn, it's measuring how much oxygen carrying capacity, how much of the hemoglobin, red blood cells, that sort of stuff is in your blood. And certainly as a freediver, we want to raise that percentage because then we can transport and store more oxygen, just like cyclists and Lance Armstrong like to do, right? So in the cycling world, there's this whole thing of doping, right? Where they're artificially cheating, increasing that method. They take human growth hormone, EPO, or now kind of the more sophisticated one is they draw their own blood out, stick it in the fridge, the day of the race, they cycle the stuff they don't want. They get rid of the plasma. They get just the red blood cells and inject that thing back in, and obviously giving them an advantage. Obviously, that's cheating. Here's the cool thing. So the last day of the intermediate course, students are typically doing 100-foot dives. So at the end of that, we got on the boat. If I drew their blood, sent it to the Olympic committee, what would happen is they get a phone call, and it goes something like this. All right, look, we don't really care what you did. I mean, in fact, you know, you're not going to get any trouble. You've got immunity, but we got to find out. What's this immersion guy doing, right? Is he giving you human growth hormones? Is it EPO? Or are you guys pulling blood? What are you doing? Your blood results clearly is over normal, so you're definitely doing something. Well, as free divers, we get it for free, right? And like I said, we've documented that in studies that we can, just from the aspect of holding our breath, compressing the spleen, and pushing that hematocrit count up. So all of these things, this dive reflex, this is why, you know, for instance, one of the things, reasons I can do what I do, and I'm teaching an intermediate class, right? You know, doing 100-foot dives, boom, 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 come up, tell them what they did right, bring the next person up, tell them what I want to remember from the last one, right? You know, there's not a lot of like, I'm breathing up, I'm talking the whole time, and I'm diving quite rapidly. So the way that I can do that is not because I'm an elite athlete in amazing shape, it's because I'm in good free diving shape. And what I mean by that is my dive reflex. My dive reflex is strong, right? So when I get in the water and I hold my breath, my body goes, okay, yeah, Ted, I know Ted, he's gonna hold his breath a lot and he's not gonna stop. He's gonna do this for a bunch of hours. So you know what, let's help the guy out, right? Let's lower the heart rate. Let's compress the spleen, you know, blood shunting some other things. So my body works very hard to make me able to do what I can do, right? So the dive reflex, we all got it, but it's different strength based on the individual, right? Now you compare me, let's say William Truebridge, right? You put us in the lab and you test us. His dive reflex, for instance, bradycardia, lowering the heart rate will kick in before mine, and the amount the heart rate drops will be more than mine. If we measure the splenic contraction, his spleen will contract before mine does, and if you look at the amount, it's gonna do more than mine. Right now, you compare me against my students. Well, now it's role reversal, right? Yeah, my heart rate's gonna lower faster and stronger than my students, right? Now you compare my students compared to, you know, Joe Blow on the street, and it's again, right, so the dive reflex is trainable. The good news is, if you want to get your dive reflex stronger, just go diving. Just hold your breath, right? So as I mentioned in the article, you know, if you don't dive all the time like most people, and you're diving, you might have maybe a month or even more off between your trips. You've probably experienced that whole thing I mentioned in the article. The first day sucks, second day's okay, third day's a little bit better, and then you go home, and the next trip you kind of go on, you have that same process. So the idea is, train your dive reflex. Leading up to that trip, sit on the couch and do dry breath holds, right? Do 3 or 4 days of those. That way, when you get to you go to your trip and you make that first drop, your body's not going, what the hell, why aren't you breathing? Your body's going, oh, yeah, I know this one. He's gonna keep doing this. He's gonna keep not breathing, so let's lower the heart rate, compress the spleen and all that sort of stuff, right? So there's some tips and advice to help make that dive reflex work for you. I hope you find this helpful. Right. So here's the deal. When we're out diving, obviously, we want to dive in teams, right? We want to be doing one up, one down, right? So when you surface, you want your buddy close enough to grab. When I say close enough to grab, I mean close within arm's reach. Because if something happens to them and you're close enough to grab, it's easy. You can fix it. You can grab hold of them, right? But, you know, the average spearfisherman, when they're surface, their buddy is 200 feet down the reef trying to shoot a bigger fish than the other guy so they can post it on Instagram, right? Spearfishermen, we had that competition, right? And that competition is like, I want to shoot the biggest fish. This is where all the big fish are. So this is my area. You go way the hell over there where all the tiny fish are, right? And so that competition, you know, drives that lack of safety, right? So we want to be one up, one down. And we want to be close enough to grab when they surface. And you need to watch that buddy for no less than 30 seconds, right? They might come up, might look fine at first, look completely fine, and then have an issue. But if you watch them for 30 seconds and they're good after 30 seconds, you can turn your back on them, go do what you need to do. Now, the common complaint I get, and I used to get this when I was scuba diving, right? Actually, when I remember when I was down the Keys and I first started spearfishing, when I knew how to do it safely, is the complaint is, well, my buddy, you know, we always get separated. We can never stay together. It just doesn't work. No, it can work. The reason it doesn't work, the reason scuba divers get separated, the reason spearfishermen get separated, is they always both think they're the leader. they're always the leader all the time. And so it's always the other person's job to follow them around. When they don't, they're like, what the hell? Why weren't you following me, right? So here's how it works. Super, super simple to employ. You get in the water. One's designated the leader and one's designated the follower. So the leader gets to go wherever they want, right? Cruise wherever they want. The follower has no say in the matter, mouth is shut, and then just follows the fin tips. They just follow that person around. The leader makes a dive, follower stays on the surface, is committed to being there close enough to grab, watch them for 30 seconds. And once that's done, switch. No talking needed, no arguing. Now the person who was the follower becomes the leader, and then they get to go wherever they want. The other person has no say in the matter, follows the fin tips, and you just cruise around. They do the dive, come up, the person's there, right? So this is a system that works effortlessly. There's no screaming, there's no yelling, there's no confusion. You do a drop, you save to the next guy. When they come up, you do a drop, they save to you. And just swap back and forth. It's a very easy way to stay together. So if you wanted to stay together with your buddy, you could just do that. All right, so hope this was helpful. Dive safe out there. It's not that hard.